Friday, Healthy Happy Hour, F2H3. I'm Angela Berg, your host. Today, I wanted to answer the way that I explain the difference between natural immune function and autoimmune function. So our normal immune system, how it works, and when does it become autoimmune disease? Because a lot of people confuse autoimmune disease for a really active immune system. So I thought it would be best if I explained, sorry ahead of time, I'm going to expose you to my bad drawing, but there's a reason I'm a nurse practitioner and not an artist. But I'm going to explain the same way that I explain to families who get a new diagnosis of autoimmune disease. So the body's normal immune system function is responsible for making lots and lots of proteins. Just thousands of proteins in our system. I call these guys the handsome Marines. They're always the well-programmed, trained, tight-knit, run like a sound machine. They know exactly how to protect us, how to fix us if something does get broken or tries to make us sick, and know their job well and are well-organized. When a hit happens to the system, that can be any number of things, from a really stressful hit to the system or a significant illness, the autoimmune system turns on. And these guys don't look quite the same. They might be missing an eye, their smile's a little crooked, they're not well trained, and they're definitely not well organized. These guys can be around in the system for a long time and not actually be active or causing autoimmune disease. So the mere fact that they're present does not diagnose an autoimmune disease. And you can have a very overactive, abundant, happy marine group. So in the case of people who have really bad allergies, for example, lots and lots of extra immunoglobulin E, which is the primary protein affecting that, can be active. So you can get lots of rashes, lots of active immune response, but it's not autoimmune until these guys that are dysfunctional actually become active and they focus on attacking us directly. So instead of the well-trained, well-organized guys who know how to fight things against us, these guys actually attack us directly. So depending on who the autoantibody is, depends on if it's attacking your joints, if it's attacking your skin, can be attacking. We see lots of kids with hair loss from their immune system causing hair loss, rashes, muscles. You get things like dermatomyositis where the muscles are attacked and we end up with generalized muscle weakness. Dermatomyositis also can attack the skin. So there are various rashes that are autoimmune related, but not all rashes, and they're usually pretty significant rashes, like the rashes associated with lupus. Lupus has a tendency to attack the heart and the kidneys most, but can also attack the liver. So there's a distinct difference between, you also cannot inherit an autoimmune disease from someone. Each individual has to have their own immune system evolve and develop, and they have to develop their own autoimmune system, disease or process. What we do know so far from the Human Genome Project is that there's got to be some gene that has the on-off switch. We just don't know all of those genes that have the on-off switches. Once we learn those on-off switches, we'll better be able to target therapy towards keeping those switches turned off and being able to predict what might turn them on. So the immune system is very complex, but there is a distinct difference that people often don't understand, the difference between a very active immune system and how autoimmunity actually happens. It's very specifically disorganized and dysfunctional antibodies that attack self tissue and do not do normal immune function at all in order for autoimmune disease to happen. These also are not known to be curable, any of these diseases. We have lots and lots of treatments to help shut down the production of these guys, but we do not know how to completely shut off. So obviously lots of research still needs to happen on the immune system, but I wanted to make sure that we go over this. And there's lots of things we can do to support the immune system in this area where it is hyperactive, or really getting a lot of asthma along with eczema lives in this overactive area where we're getting an abundance of these proteins made from primarily immunoglobulin E, which can cause a lot of inflammation. That's also not autoimmune inflammation. So that's the basic nuts and shells, not the science version. There's a reason I'm your nurse practitioner and not your scientist. And there's a reason I'm not an artist. But if you stay with us soon, I'll be back with Amy and we'll talk about oils to support the immune system and oils that are specifically really helpful for a very active immune system during times of allergy season as well. So don't go away. We'll be right back. Stay where you are.
And I'm Grant, paramedics with AMR. We're here today with our friend Marley, and we're here with Cure for Kids Foundation.
We would like to invite you out for Cuts for the Kids on Sunday, September 15th at Mosaic Salon. This is in support of kids battling cancer.
The price you pay for a haircut will be donated to the Cure for the Kids Foundation to help children affected by cancer, but who do not have medical insurance or cannot afford treatment.
This is the 10th year that Mosaic Salon at Boca Park and its stylists have volunteered their talents so that all proceeds go to Cure for the Kids Foundation's charity care program.
We're inviting first responders and the public to help raise money by getting your haircut on Sunday, September 15th at Mosaic Salon at Boca Park. Appointments are available by calling 702-373-2108.
Let's make sure all the kids here in Nevada get the support that they need.
Join us September 15th at Cut for the Kids.
Thanks for staying with us with all our exciting discussion about immunity and autoimmunity today. So while we're talking about the immune system, there's a lot of essential oils that tie into helping support our immune system for protection and for helping boost when we're dealing with some overactive immune system in terms of allergies. So Amy's going to talk today about some of our oil choices, and of course our always favorite staple that we probably talk about four times a year at least, On Guard.
Exactly.
So I'm going to turn it over to you, Amy.
Oh my gosh, I love On Guard. And it's so funny because we have a tendency to always come back to it because it's such a key oil, and it is a blend. Mm-hmm. Now, it's a blend from doTERRA. I'll give you all the ingredients that are in it. So if you wanted to create your own, you know, you don't have to use doTERRA, but this is what we use every day because of their standards. And in wild orange, so this is the wild orange oil. In the wild orange is in the On Guard oil. In the On Guard is wild orange, clove, cinnamon, eucalyptus, and rosemary. Those are the key oils. So it's wild orange, clove, cinnamon, rosemary, and eucalyptus. And On Guard is one of the best immune boosting blends out there. I mean, there have been, if you can Google it, there have been studies on On Guard there have been fifth grade classes that have done scientific experiments with mm-hmm, it, which mm-hmm. is very cool. You can diffuse it. You can put it with a carrier oil, like fractionated coconut oil, and rub it on children's feet or on your own feet. It feels really good. It's like a massage. Or get your children to rub your feet.
There you go, even better.
That's even better. So, yes, On Guard is one of the best oils to maintain a healthy immune system.
So even diffusing it works really well mm-hmm. in the clinic when there was a sickness running around among the staff. And, you know, we're already working with a skeleton crew sometimes, and you don't want people dropping like flies. I actually put my little mini diffusers in two places in the clinic, and aside from everybody saying, gosh, it smells so good in here, because it did happen to be during flu season, so it was in the fall, and it's a very good fall scent with that blend of clove and cinnamon, but it really helped cut down everybody spreading the infection. I don't know if the scent makes everybody remember extra to wash their hands. I think we're pretty good about that in the clinic anyway. But yeah, it really did help kind of break the cycle that we were experiencing in the clinic with having so many people going out sick yes. and spreading it around.
Well, and they actually have, I don't have the bottle out here, they have On Guard soft gels, and the minute anybody around me is sick or if I start feeling a little bit of a sore throat, I immediately start taking those soft gels. And typically, I can hold off just about anything. Mm-hmm. And they really do help. So if you have On Guard soft gels, definitely take them at the first sign of a cold. I remember I was first introduced to On Guard probably 6 or 7 years ago when I had a cold. A friend said, oh, here, take these. And I said, there's essential oils. How's that going to help me? Like, seriously, it's essential oil. You know, I need to go get my Sudafed or my Dayquil or whatever. Well, once I started using the On Guard, it knocks it out. Mm-hmm. But you can't wait till you're full-blown sick. You know, it really holds it off. And now I can't live without them. And I'm thinking, man, I could have been doing this all these years.
The soft gels are a good point. There's another one that I didn't, that just came to me when all the illness was going around in the clinic. Of course, Tamara makes fun of me with all my peyote and my potions, she calls them. But I also did the Copaiba soft gels. Oh, so for yes. throat infections, those are incredibly helpful. And so I did a combination. So now, just so that everybody knows, one of the best kept secrets is the providers. Several of them even came to me and said, mm-hmm. I don't feel so good. What do you have today? So they all go out with a little baggie of Copaiba and On Guard soft gels cool. to get them back up and running, because we need them taking care of our kids.
Definitely. And you mentioned washing your hands, and I think this is probably the one product that I've turned more people onto. Mm-hmm. This is the foaming hand wash. Actually, you get a dispenser with it, and I have it in every room in my house, and I swear that washing your hands with On Guard does that little extra mm-hmm. to make sure you don't have anything mm-hmm. on your hands, and it smells so good. Everybody mm-hmm. loves washing their hands at my house. They're like, mm-hmm. I love this. But the On Guard hand soap is some of the best, and then their cleaner concentrate. Mm-hmm. So both of these are made with On Guard, so you're getting the benefits just washing your hands. I use the cleaner concentrate to do all of my dishes, to clean my counters off at mm-hmm. home. I dilute it. There's instructions on the side how to dilute it. But then I know that I'm using something non-toxic in my kitchen on my dishes, and I'm not getting the toxicity of, you know, regular cleaning stuff.
Absolutely.
So On Guard's great.
You know what else the On Guard has? The little that I carry in my bag, spray hand sanitizer.
Oh, yes.
And that's fabulous, even for flying, being able to. I used to make fun of the people who you would see with their wipies wiping down their whole zone and when they get in the plane. But I don't know if any of you have seen how absolutely tacky, gross some of those trays can be. So before I want to set my computer on the little tray to work while I'm on the airplane, I'll even use the hand sanitizer with the tissue and just wipe down. Plus, it smells so darn good then there, and you know, in that enclosed space.
Heck yeah. And the On Guard is also a great gift to give to teachers.
Yeah,
our hand sanitizer or the soap. It's very, very good to give to teachers. Also, I was just going to mention, these are On Guard beadlets. Have you tried the On Guard beadlets?
I haven't done the beadlets. I do the caps, the little capsules.
Yes, I do the capsules. Beadlets. On Guard is kind of, because it has the cinnamon and clove, it's kind of hot.
Mm-hmm.
And these are little beadlets you're supposed to pop in your mouth so you get it internally. For me personally, I find them to be too spicy. Mm. Like, they're kind of spicy. Some people love them. But what I think these are excellent for is a swallowing pill trainer.
Oh,
so
yeah.
If, because my daughter, who is 9, she cannot swallow pills, but she wants to learn. These are itty, itty, itty bitty, and you can swallow it like a pill, and it's a great way
to practice,
and you're getting the benefits of boosting your immune system.
It's better than the M&Ms, which I usually tell people to use for training on pills.
So they have peppermint beadlets, and they have the On Guard.
Yeah.
And
I use the peppermint beadlets a lot for headaches, so yeah, I haven't even paid attention to those being in beadlets.
Yeah, so I use the peppermint for my bad breath, but, you know, it's like Altoids are really good, really strong. But, yeah, the On Guard beadlets, though, I think, to me, that's the best use of these is training kids to take pills.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
Excellent for that. And it's smaller than an M&M, so they can, like, graduate to M&Ms after that, or Tic Tacs.
That's true. Right? That's true.
They won't even notice it. Yeah, so On Guard has a lot of uses and is...
So that's really protective benefits and helping us fight once we've gotten something as far as illness-wise, virus, managing virus loads. What about, let's talk about the things that really cause a lot of problems and is a gazillion-dollar industry now because so many people are developing allergies.
Yes.
And I know a lot of you feel my pain. So let's talk about what are some of the oils that are really beneficial to us for helping with the allergy response.
Okay, absolutely. I do want to say one more thing about On Guard I just thought of.
Okay.
If you're in a family where the kid can have low immunity and low ANC, keep the whole family on On Guard. That was just, I
keeps
just wanted
from bringing anything home. That's
right. Just wanted
right.
to do that side note for the kids that have that low ANC. But yes, Tri-Ease is a soft gel that you can take for allergies, for seasonal threats. At the first sign of a runny nose, you know, not a cold, but you know it's something else, you could take Tri-Ease. Now, if you don't have Tri-Ease, you can get a soft gel and put lemon, peppermint, and lavender.
And nice and simple.
Nice and simple. It's just the Tri-Ease. Yep, I'm making sure I got the right ingredients.
So even diffusing those as a blend would probably be a very nice scented blend for diffusing in the house during allergy season.
As a matter of fact, it's interesting. Those are typically the three essential oils that people get started with when they're starting their essential oil journey. You know, a lot of people want to try lemon for the kitchen or lavender for sleep, peppermint for tummy aches.
Mm.
So those are really the main three primary oils that kind of get started. I started with those and now, like, I got like tons of oils. But those three oils together are diffused. You could even rub them on, and it's really, they have great benefits for kind of that allergy stuff going on.
Specific to the immunoglobulins that are triggered for the response.
Yeah.
That makes a lot of sense. Good.
Yeah, I love those. And then the only other oil I have sitting down there for immune response is DDR Prime, which is stands for DNA damage repair. And that really goes down to the cellular level. And we have it in oil and, again, in soft gels to take internally. But a combination of all these will help you stay happy and healthy.
Yes,
right?
Exactly. The DDR Prime, just as a side note, I have been experimenting with it in an oil for topical for some of the kids with skin conditions and finding it very helpful. It has combine it with helichrysum, and it's got some amazing skin healing benefits. So there's lots of opportunity there at a cellular level.
And again, if any of them are too strong, straight as an oil, you always want to use a carrier oil when you're putting it on topically. But yeah, can't go wrong with On Guard. Seriously, you cannot.
Keeps you healthy and happy. Such a warm, happy scent, too. So, good. Awesome. Thank you. As Amy always brings good information to us about oils, and I love having you here as a partner. Thanks for staying with us. And again, until we see you next time, stay healthy and stay happy.